Hello everyone. Today was another leg day, but it was more of a high rep accessory leg day. What I mean by accessory leg day is more concentrated on the smaller muscles of the glutes and hamstrings and not necessarily heavy compound movements, but more detail work with a little bit lighter weight. Still very challenging, but the higher reps keep it extremely challenging and you don't have to go heavy with the weight. So in this cycle, I've been doing high reps but moderate weight and then lower reps with heavy weight. So I don't ever do any light reps, lightweight. I'm always keeping it very challenging as I'm doing this workout. I'd like to thank Diesel Muscle for providing me with a great place to train while I've been in the Tempe, Scottsdale, Arizona area. So thank you for providing me with a wonderful place to train while I've been here. Today's workout consisted of 23 sets for legs to include goblet squats, machine hip thrusts, sissy squats, glute ham raise, glute adductors, and seated calf raises. One thing that I want you to take note of in this video is how I perform the glute ham raises. Now, there are several different variations of glute ham raises, and in this version, I'm holding a plate, but I'm keeping my arms and my lats in a locked position. I also do glute ham raises on a higher platform where I will extend my arms out and get a good stretch in my back and then retract my lats, lock them in, and then do a glute ham raise. In this version, I'm just keeping my arms and my lats locked in a position because this doesn't have the length for me to extend my arms and also perform a back movement, upper back movement at the same time. In addition, I also want you to observe that I'm not hyperextending my lower back. I'm coming up just enough to feel a squeeze in the glutes and the hamstrings, but I am not hyperextending. Oftentimes I see people swinging and using momentum in the glute ham raise and hyperextending their lower back. Again, you don't need to do that because then you're just putting yourself at risk for lower back injury. I really like the seated calf machine that they have here. It's called a super calf and it's plate loaded. I feel like I get a really good stretch when I use that machine, and I feel like I've made some decent progress in my calves because of that machine. It's hard to find that, and I really do enjoy the type of equipment that they have at this gym. See the videos from today, and you might also see some videos that I've done earlier in the week from my leg workout. And if you like this video, I hope that you subscribe and share it. And thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.